this side is in the middle of nowhere. There's nothing, there's no entertainment. You have to work, you have to stay with your instrument. The life is tough here. But the result they get is really exciting, it's really exciting. There are people from different institutions, from different universities, from all over the world. Each group study different, study different things, have their different focuses on aerosols. So by collaborations with them, we can find some correlations between molecule A and molecule B.
So the next step is to really understand the data in the sense we want to see how the emissions from the trees are interacting with the pollution, how that changes the chemical properties of the particles, how that changes how much of the particles are formed during this process, and then seeing how these particles can interact with solar radiation and clouds to affect climate. The ultimate goal, and this would be the really awesome part, is to put this data inside of climate models so we can actually predict to see how much these particles are affecting the regional climate. And this is for us the, you know, $64,000 question. The Southeast is one of the few places on the planet that hasn't experienced a lot of global warming. And we think it's because of these particles.